preacher, all you have to do is say amen. Amen. Because you already have something in you that's seeing it. Amen. Amen. So praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And the Bible says, and when they went to buy oil, amen, and they returned back after the prophet's vision, they started to run back now. Praise God. Hallelujah. One stage of it, some of them got discouraged because people spreading all kinds of stuff about the message. And they started to drift off, drift away. Prophet prophesied it. Drifting here and running after, food and running after a job and running after, I marry a wife, I'm busy, I buy a new house, I'm too busy, I gotta fix it. I buy cattle to fix it, I got this to do, legitimate stuff. He says, yeah, they're drifting away. He says, but they will return in the evening time. Only some will make it.
Amen.
But the rest, by the time they get back, the Bible says, and the door was shut.
Yes.
The door. Understand and receive revelation yes. will be taken away at that time.
Amen.
Jesus in Revelation 1 says, I am he that hold the key of David.
Yes.
Is that right?
Amen.
I open the door and no man shut it, and I shut it and no man open.
Yes.
I'm not talking about the door of St. Peter in Rome that the Pope got a knock with a hammer 7 times. But he's talking about the door of our understanding. When I open your understanding to see this word,
amen.
See this God, nobody can explain it away from you.
Hallelujah.
And if I don't want you to catch this, that's you can be like a Pharisee right there. And I'm speaking parables. The preaching of the gospel is something like I'm speaking in tongues. Because you don't understand. You hear it with your ears, but you don't understand what is really, what in the world is going on. I shut the no man open. I open the
door.
Are you with me, heaven?
Yes.
Are you with me tonight?
Yes.
Are you backing me up and praying me? What am I preaching? Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. I don't want you just to listen, but pray and say, God, anoint and bless you. Speak the word to his mouth. Glory to God. Hallelujah. This thing is a supernatural. The preaching of the gospel is not just getting up and talking words, but that God will find a voice. Speak his word and go the lights.
Amen.
Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Amen. And so the doors were shut and they could not enter in anymore. Is that right? Oh my goodness, you stop and think. Just let your mind run through the scripture. I'm going to touch these things short because I can't go into them. You remember the other scripture? And Esau sought repentance with tears. The bread was right in his hand. The message was right there in front of him. He could have took it. He could have held on to it. But instead of that, he sold out. Amen. And the Bible says after he sold out, and later on when he realized it was the truth, it was a real prophet. It was thus saith the Lord.
Amen.
Every teaching is right. It was not this or that. It was thus saith the Lord.
Amen.
The Bible says, oh, Esau saw repentance with the tears. But there was no place found for him. No place was found for him. Amen. His name was not in the book.
Amen.
Praise God. It's not like God scratching out names now.
No.
Because God knows every name from before the foundations of the world.
Yes.
There's no such thing as the old Pentecostals. There's a new name written down in glory, and it's mine. Oh, yes, it's mine. No, no. There's no new name going to be written in that book. Your name is only going to be recognized because it's already in the book.
Amen.
And it's you who are going to have to recognize it, and God has to speak back that he recognized it.
Amen.
Is that right? But your name is already in the Lamb's book of life.
Amen.
Surely your name is in the book of life. Every living thing that ever come on this earth, God has a book with everybody and every insect and every ant and everything is in that book. So your name is in the book of natural life, right? But the Lamb's book of life, that's the book of redemption.
Amen.
Amen. All those whose names were not found written in the book, the seed.
Yes.
The seed. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Oh my. Praise God. Hallelujah. Now the doors are closing. Does that contradict the gospel? Where Jesus talked about the gospel being preached into all the world? Do you know that in literal fact, almost all the nations already heard the gospel? In some form or the other, whether from the first age, second age, third age, but the gospel already went to some of these nations. Every individual within those nations may not have heard the gospel. But of all these nations, regardless of who they are, they heard the gospel.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Now we are at the end, we are here to wrap things up. We are here before the oncoming storm hits. We are there to rescue the perishing, care for the dying, snatch them in pity from sin and the grave. Weep over the erring one, lift up the fallen, tell them of Jesus the mighty Savior. That's what we are here for, brothers and sisters. That's the gospel that we are preaching here tonight. In this church, I don't know what the other message churches are telling the people, but I know what God has put in my heart to tell you. Amen. That's the gospel that we are preaching. We preach about the prophet, we preach about the Lord, we preach all these things, but we preach the gospel pure and simple.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Is this complicated to you?
No, sir.
Amen. You have to have a message degree to understand what I'm talking about. You have to know every quote and every book and every chapter and verse and month when Brother Branham says a certain thing to know what you're hearing. Brother Branham said it'll be so simple that
yes.
A fearing man, though he be a fool, will not stumble therein. But the power is in the simplicity.
Amen.
The more it looks simple, it's the most powerful it
is. Amen.
Is that right?
Yes.
Praise God. But you know what? When it's some simple, it's despised.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus comes simple, despised.
Yes.
It's rejected. It's the human mind and being. They love ostentatious things. They love diamonds, shiny things. They love gold. They love fool's gold. You know, human beings are caught up with monkey business. Monkey see and monkey do. They see something shiny, they grab it. They don't know what it is and the rest puts on their mouth. Like that. That's the gospel. I'm preaching now. Listen to what I'm saying here.
Amen.
Let the Holy Spirit speak to your heart.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Oh my. That's what we are facing, brother. Amen. But I preach it and I believe it that in the middle of this Laodicean condition, we can live like Daniel, godly and clean, right in the middle of battle.
Amen.
Amen. God, be called out for a purpose.
Amen.
Called out for his purpose, for his glory. Amen. Oh my. Will the gospel be preached to all nations? Amen. Will Jesus' words not be fulfilled? Amen. Praise the Lord. But we know that they heard the gospel. We know that the whole of Asia Minor, you know already Paul preached there?
Mm-hmm.
But what has happened is that after he preached the gospel and many of them received it and it spread all over, amen, the Bible, they even say to the Bible, the whole world, the whole then known world, had already received the gospel. Now Rome, all those nations, but what happened? After the gospel become despised, they become re-paganized. But nevertheless, they heard the gospel. But they come re-paganized. You know, even in India, the gospel was preached. Thomas went there and preached all over India, preaching the gospel.
Amen.
And the Hindus stabbed him and killed him right there. And they still have his tomb in India. He is the patron saint, according to certain churches, of India. Because he's the one who went there and preached the gospel to them. So the gospel was preached.
Amen.
But the people, they come re-paganized. Amen. And so, it's not just reaching mass crusades, reaching nations anymore, but we are here to do like Ruth, the gleanings.
Amen.
The gleanings. Amen. One here, one there, five there, ten there, wherever. We're gleaning in the field.
Amen.
And while we're working, we're waiting for boss to come.
Amen.
Hallelujah. To say, come up, give up.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Are you with me tonight?
Amen.
Amen.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Oh, my. Yes, sir. The the gospel come and men have turned from it. Nations have turned from it. That's right, they turned away from it. And the reason why they turned around from it, because as you would read 2 Thessalonians 2, 7-12, 2 Thessalonians, I believe it is 2:7-12 here. We read the scripture before. Listen to what it says. For the mystery, Brother Brown talked about it, of iniquity doth already work. In other words, it's already working in the first church age. The Satan is already working in the first church age. Only he who now letteth, and I've explained this to you before, the Greek says letteth. He who allows will let, hinders, will hinder until he be taken out of the way. This is speaking of the Holy Spirit who is now hindering Satan. Mm-hmm. Right? Because of him in us and in the world, he is hindering Satan from having full control.
Amen.
Is that right? So he who letteth will let until he be taken out of the way. In other words, he who hinders will continue hindering until he is taken out of the way.
Amen.
When the Holy Spirit leaves there, tribulation begins.
Amen.
Is that right? When the Holy Spirit takes us out, tribulation begins. This is what he's talking about here. Now, then shall the wicked be revealed. Now the devil can come open. Now the false church can come open. Is that right? Now, every one of whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming, even him whose coming is after the working of Satan, with lying, with all power and signs and lying wonders, and with all the deceivableness of unrighteousness, in them that perish. See, in them that perish. In other words, he's going to work truly ungodly people. Are you following me? He's going to work his deceivableness, his lying, and everything else through the ungodly, right? They're open to receive his inspiration, his anointing, and everything upon them. And there'll be vessels that he will be able to use and is already using. Amen. Hallelujah. Because they receive not the love of the truth, that they might be saved. And for this cause, God shall send them strong. That they should believe a lie. That they might be damned who believe not the truth, but have pleasure in unrighteousness. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. I'm going to stop there at that point. You can read these scriptures as I'm tying them together and recognize your name, your message, and what God is saying to you at this particular time. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. So we are showing you here that the Holy Spirit is already, it's not one day all of a sudden the Holy Spirit is going to take off his hand and tribulation begin the next morning. But Brother Brennan said that these things happen, you are welcome, Pastor. Praise the Lord. My brother Andre Petit and his precious wife, Sister Suzanne, have just entered the building from Quebec. They go to Washington and come right in. It's all right. But praise the Lord. The fact is, the Holy Spirit does not take his hands off of the world one certain day or night. And then tribulation begins tomorrow. Brother Branham says the ages phase in as one is going out, one is coming in. And they overlap. Right? They overlap like that. Right now, physically, we are in the seventh church age. Physically, you're in the seventh church age. Spiritually, you're being transformed as the eighth day or the rapture time comes in.
Amen.
Is that right?
Amen.
And we are being taken out of here on the inspiration of the mighty angel through the rapture revelation of this hour.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. What a season, what a time that they're living in. So, we find out that the Holy Spirit is already leaving. You can look around and see. The Holy Spirit is already leaving. Revelation 20. Let's go back to Revelation 20. God bless you. You're welcome, brother, sister. Revelation 20. Let's go back to Revelation 20. Read the scripture here. We read, first of all, 1 to 3. About this angel, how he laid hold on the dragon. And listen to verse 3. And cast him into the bottomless pit, and shut him up, and shut the seal upon him, that he should deceive the nations no more. Now, think carefully. At the time of the millennium, he will be cast into the bottomless pit, and chained there, sealed him, that he might deceive the nations no more. Are you following me now?
Yes.
That means that he is right now deceiving the nations.
Amen.
He is right now deceiving the nations to the word of God and the message of his hour.
Amen.
But at that time, he will be changed. Mm-hmm. I'll prove it to you. Listen, let's go down to verse 7 and 8. Listen what it says in verse 7 and 8. And when the 1,000 years are expired, Satan shall be loosed out of his prison. And what's going to happen? He goes out back again. And shall go out to deceive the nations which are in the four quarters of the earth, God and Magog, and gather them together to battle, the number of whom is as the sand of the sea. You can read about that in the book of Ezekiel, I believe. Also, at the time when he will gather those nations, there, the Libyans, the Ethiopians, and names. Nations are actually mentioned there. And major cities like Moscow and Tobolsk in Russia, the names are right in the Bible. You can find it right there if you study it in the book of Ezekiel. But Satan is right now out there deceiving the nations.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
But those whose names are written in the Lamb's book of life shall not be deceived.
Amen. Amen.
But you know what? He spread his culture, his intelligence. He'll create a Satan's Eden. He'll capture the people by wisdom, by knowledge, by science, by this, by that, and by glamour, every means that he has to play on the five senses and intellectuals of man. He will use those tools to deceive the nation.
Amen.
And make those of us who believe the word of God push you into we are the minority, but he's going to push you into a condition where you are made to look like you are lost your mind, like you're crazy. Don't listen to them. Something's wrong with them. They're calling names like cult, like curse, holy rollers and everything else. And Jews that they're insane and stuff like that. But really, we are not the ones that are crazy.
Amen.
Is that right? They're the ones crazy.
Amen.
And we know it. The devil can't get us because a prophet already prophesied. Amen. It shall come to pass in the last days, all the world will go and say, except for the members of the bride of Christ.
Amen.
Why? Because we have a right mind now.
Amen.
We have the mind of Christ.
Amen.
Insane. We used to live in sin.
Yeah.
And that's to be insane.
Mm-hmm.
But when you took away your sins, you put on the mind of Christ.
Amen.
And you now have your right mind.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Somebody say
amen. Amen.
Somebody say thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
And the right mind, praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. Satan is loose. And his entire purpose for his life, what a life, is just to deceive. It's like when Micaiah went before Jehoshaphat and Ahab and said, you don't mean you don't have one more prophet that can prophesy the truth? Amen. And they said, well, I have one, but he hate me. He always preaching against me. He's not falling in line with all the seminaries of the Bible school and all those theological places. He's not falling in line with them. But he's always preaching against me like that. Amen. Hallelujah. Wow. And you know, Micaiah talks about this vision that he had of a lion spirit went up before God.
Yes.
And asked God, he said, allow me to go down. I'm going to convince him. I'm going to lie and I'm going to deceive him. And everything else. Because that light spirit went into the mouth of those 400 prophets.
Mm-hmm.
Is that right?
Yes.
Brother Branham went there to Chicago, 350 or 400 of them met him up there, and they could not withstand the wisdom by which he spake.
Mm-hmm.
They could not defeat him. They could not expose anything false in his doctrines of the serpent seed, marriage and divorce, this and that. He said, any one of you that can show me any doctrine, any teaching, anything I said that was wrong, you have liberty to come up here and expose me, call me a false prophet, put a sign on my back, march me through the streets. I will allow you to do that. And he waited. Mm-hmm. And nobody came up. He says, then get off my back.
Amen.
Amen. You know, some of them start to cry and face the truth. Brother Branham, we're going to get baptized tomorrow morning. We're going to be here. Brother Branham got up the next morning and went to baptize them. Everyone fly out. Every one of those 400 prophets gone. You know what they start to do? Oh, he's a false prophet. They forgot they wrote the book. A man sent from God. 20th century prophet. He didn't write it. They write it. Amen. Oh my! Now they start talking. Oh, you know, if he had stayed with prophesying, that was fine. But he started to try to teach, and he didn't go to seminary. He only had an 8th grade education. They don't even know what a prophet is.
Right.
Amen.
It doesn't mean God has to go to school. You don't understand that when a prophet speaks, God is in the man.
Amen.
And speaking out with his mouth.
Amen. Amen.
And he's telling you, this is not William Branham speaking, thus saith the Lord.
Amen.
It's right in front of you. He's telling you, this is not William Branham, this is, I'm speaking. Amen. Matter of fact, you can go to the old, if you find the old tape looking to the unseen, you'll actually hear that voice saying, this is not William Branham speaking. I am the Lord, come down. William Branham has only loaded me, his body and his voice.
Amen.
That's what a prophet is. Yes. It's God in the man, the voice of God. He said, don't look at the signpost. Listen to the voice.
Amen.
Not only a signpost, listen to the voice. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God. And now that he's gone, he says, the voice is now in the bride.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The voice is in the bride. The message
Amen.
Is in you.
Yes.
Christ in you, your hope of glory. Christ is the mystery of God now being revealed. God in your skin, and God unveiling himself in your skin. God hiding in simplicity, revealing himself in the sand. Is that right?
Yes.
Don't you understand? You are the unrecognized presence of God.
Amen.
You are now the super sign or the true sign now being one of us.
Amen.
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 Me? Yeah. Gideon, oh, thou mighty man of valor, you're in the brain. Who, me? I'm the poorest of the poor. Look at the mistakes I made. Look at what I've done here. Look at what I've done there. Nevertheless, the angels said, you don't even know your own potential. You don't even know your purpose. You don't know what is inside of you. I am telling you, the mighty man of valor. Hallelujah! Glory to God!
Amen.
Go forth and defeat them!
Amen.
With a lamp in your hand.
Amen.
There will be a door.
Hurry
out. Oh, praise God!
Amen.
I'm happy that you can say I'm one of them.
Amen.
I'm happy I can say I'm one of them. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So Satan is going to deceive the nations, but because we are here and we are preaching the message, even though we don't have the greatest loudspeakers, we don't have the biggest ministries, and we don't have the largest churches with 20,000 members and everything else, but don't you make any mistake about it. The devil's greatest enemy in the world today is the message of this hour.
Amen.
That's his greatest enemy.
Amen.
Many years ago, one of the popes took the back of one of these other spoken words book and turned it with the eagle showing and said, this is our greatest enemy. Amen. He didn't show the front, but he turned the back with the eagle on it and said, this is our greatest enemy. I think it was in Poland. Amen. Yes, sir. And the devil knows that as long as message people are still around, being the salt of the earth, they will continue to preserve things around them.
Mm-hmm.
And we are, as he would say, we are a bad influence on the rest of the people. But we're not a bad influence. We are sending forth the influence of another. And that is Christ upon the people. And he hates that. He hates it so much, brother and sister. Amen. Yes, sir. So this message, this gospel, you say, what are you talking about, brother? The Baptists are preaching, the Catholics, this one, they're preaching the gospel too. You think you're so special, every one of them are preaching. Yes, they're preaching. But many of them preaching the gospel from another age. They're preaching dried up bread that sits on the ground and corrupt and everything else. And you're picking it up. You're talking about the spiritual food in Jew season, the word for this day. Fresh food for the hour. That's what the people are supposed to eat. Praise the name of the Lord. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So, we're not talking about a steady gospel, because Paul talks to some of them are going to preach another gospel. Amen. And all
because of the environment and the
come out and say they're gay. They couldn't say that they're this or they're that. Back in the old country where I'm from, if people found out that somebody was like that, they have to run for their lives. They wouldn't have such people around whatsoever.
Right.
Now, don't take that to say, or take this little clip to say that I'm advocating going out there and chasing people that claim to be gay. That's not what I'm saying. I'm saying it used to happen way back then. But after a while, it started to become acceptable.
Yeah.
You know, and after a while, they acculturate themselves within the society to the point now they can, as they say, out. They can come out plainly and proudly with pride. Say, I am happy living this way. Huh? Oh my! But that's where we are in this hour. That's the season that we are out, friends. Amen. So Satan is now, I'll lay that background to tell you that Satan's prime objective is to hinder this message, this gospel of the kingdom, which should be preached into all the world, that shall be entered. Now, that's his objective. That is his ambition, to hinder this message.
Mm-hmm.
He's not going to hinder the Catholic Church. Why would he hinder them? He's not going to hinder this one, that one, whatever. They don't have the name of Christ on them.
That's right.
Amen? Mm-hmm. They baptized Mr. Baptist, they married to Mr. Methodist, Mr. Lutheran, they take his name on. I'm a member of this church. They fight and kill for that church more than they fight for the name of Jesus. They don't even want to bear the reproach for the word, but they'll fight for a church.
Amen.
Right? So they're married to that. But thank God, we are married to Christ.
Amen.
To an invisible union.
Amen.
With our heart. And because of that, we are carrying his name.
Amen.
And we are proud to carry the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And we said, I'm a Christian. I'm serving the Lord. I'm reading my Bible. I believe in God's word. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Never be the name of the Lord. Glory to God. Is that the Bible?
Amen.
Is that the truth?
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I'm winding this up now. Glory to God forevermore. Amen. And listen, friends, I'm telling you, just today, this has come to me quickly here. This is not something I have there. But do you know who remember Jim Baker?
Mm-hmm.
From the Praise the Lord, PTL,
mm-hmm.
from many years ago.
Mm-hmm.
So has gone, that let me tell you, the gospel so-called and the religious ranks have gone so low that he is saying that if a certain man is impeached, and I'm saying that to protect myself from lawsuits, or anything like that. A certain man is impeached. He says, all Christians in the United States of America ought to break out in civil war. Mm-hmm. It's on the internet.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't believe me, go search his name and look it up. He's calling for civil war if a certain man is impeached for his lying, his immorality, his cheating, his this, his that, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
We don't care what he did. If anybody tried to kick him out of there, war.
Mm-hmm.
Only saying it, that it's ought to be, and Christians, he's saying, ought to go to war. I wonder which Christians.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder which Christians he's talking to. Amen. Are you one of them?
Yes,
amen. My. Oh, tell you. But listen, he doesn't realize what nature is manifesting because Satan's nature is the war.
Mm-hmm.
Is that right?
Yes.
Matter of fact, he is the originator of war.
Yes.
He is the inventor of war. He is the inventor, inspired Nimrod to make weapons and evil things and organize people into battalions to go attack and start wars and conquer countries and nations and everything else like that. Amen. Yes, sir. So this is what's happening. Glory to God. Amen. And we know that after a while he will have a war because he'll take Russia up there along with China and many other countries.